Right, protests are being held across the Palestinian territories over Donald Trump's decision to recognize Jerusalem as the capital of Israel. Trump also gave the go-ahead to move the American embassy from Tel Aviv to Jerusalem, which has long been contested by Israelis and Palestinians. Here are pictures from the West Bank. Protesters have been burning tires and throwing objects at Israeli security forces, which have responded with tear gas and water cannons. Authorities say dozens of people have been injured. A producer from RT Arabic was caught up in the unrest and needed medical assistance. Protests against Trump's decision have been spreading across the Middle East as well.
Therefore, I have determined that it is time to officially recognize Jerusalem as the capital of Israel.
No one has the right to play with the fate of billions of people for the sake of one's personal ambitions.
Ignoring the Palestinian Muslim and Christian rights in Jerusalem will only fuel further extremism and undermine the war against terrorism.
They cannot oppose people's feelings and beliefs. This is a new type of adventurism and global arrogance of the U.S.
King Salman made our position clear during his telephone conversation with President Trump. Saudi Arabia's policy regarding the Palestinians will never change. The Palestinian issue is a primary concern to us.
We warned the U.S. that Jerusalem may stay Arab. We've warned of the consequences that would occur in case the U.S. and President Trump took this decision, which will damage U.S. relations with the Arab nations.
There are reports that dozens have been injured in clashes in the West Bank and that live fire has been used. The Israeli military denies the use of live rounds, though. Palestinians are holding a general strike with more protests expected over the coming days. The Islamist group Hamas has called for a new uprising and declared Friday a day of rage. Israelis as well as Palestinians have voiced their fears over Trump's decision.
No one knows what will happen, but dangerous days are coming to Jerusalem.
That is definitely my short-term fear, that it will spark violence. Hopefully it won't. And I think that, unfortunately, a U.S. president makes a statement and the Israeli citizens will need to pay the price for it.
There has been a strong international backlash to Trump's decision. Nadira Tudor was in the studio earlier with the latest.
So the immediate reaction after Trump declared Jerusalem as the recognized capital of Israel was concern about how it would affect the Arab world. A number of world powers have expressed their grave concern. But now one militia group in Iraq, they have come out with this direct threat against the U.S. because of Trump's decision. And if that threat comes to fruition, there are really serious consequences there.
Trump's stupid decision will be the big spark for removing Israel from the body of the Islamic nation, and a legitimate reason to target American forces.
So what do we know then about this militia group?
Well, the name of the group is Harakat Hezbollah al-Mujaba. It's a prominent militia group, Shia militia group, and it's made up of around 10,000 Iraqis. And they're also part of the Iran-backed popular mobilization forces, and it is considered to be one of the most important militia groups there.
And if this threat is real, as it appears to be, how many people will be a target?
Well, we can't forget how many people have been sent on a large-scale operation, according to the U.S. Defense Department, and these are the latest figures. Apparently, there's around 5,200 troops there in the country, an awful lot of troops to be affected if these threats become a reality.
That's the situation in Iraq there, but it's potentially not only those soldiers there that could be at risk too.
No, not at all. There have been worries, again, about the fact that Trump has come out and said that the embassy, the US embassy, will be moved to Jerusalem. What are the consequences of that? Never mind moving it, it will become an absolute target for various terrorist groups. We've seen it in the past in Benghazi, if you remember then, in Libya. In fact, there were two coordinated attacks that were carried out by militant groups there. So we've already seen US embassies, consulates, government buildings attacked around in conflict areas. And what does that mean for the US staff now who are thinking about or who will be forced to move to Jerusalem as and when that happens? They're going to be really worried.
That was Nadira Tudor speaking with my colleague Andy Farmer earlier. Now, we asked Professor of Political Sociology, Dr. Saeed Sadiq, whether he thought the Shia militias would follow through on their threat against US forces in Iraq.
I don't think that this group is able to really attack a highly armed American force. It's just a threat, and I don't think it will be translated because they know that American will respond in a more aggressive way if this happens. But you have to also take into consideration that there is a war, proxy war inside Iraq between Iran and the United States. And this group also has links to Iran. And Iran feels that this is a time where you can, with all this Muslim anger against the United States, that such operations can take place even if it can lead to trouble.
All right, European leaders and the UN were also quick to voice their concerns, calling Washington's step radical.
This is a regrettable decision which France does not approve of and which contradicts international law and UN Security Council resolutions.
Recognizing Jerusalem as the capital of Israel does not calm a conflict. Rather, it fuels it even more. It's in everyone's interest that that does not happen.
It is a very fragile context, and the announcement has the potential to send us backwards to even darker times than the ones we are already living in.
We disagree with the US decision to move its embassy to Jerusalem and recognize Jerusalem as Israeli capital before a final status agreement. We believe it is unhelpful in terms of prospects for peace in the region.
Jerusalem is considered sacred by Jews, Muslims, and Christians. The Jewish quarter of the city is home to the Western Wall, believed to be the last remnant of the second Jewish temple, which was destroyed by the Romans. Now, the city is also home to the shrine of the Dome of the Rock, the oldest Islamic monument still in existence. And also the Al-Qasa Mosque, the third holiest site in Islam. Now, the city is at the very heart of the decades-long conflict between the Israelis and the Palestinians. Israel calls Jerusalem its eternal capital. They claim most of the international community rejects. And because of the dispute, no countries have an embassy there. Now, the western part of the city is predominantly Israeli, while the eastern part has a Palestinian majority. And the city's holy sites are always a sensitive issue. And when threatened, there has often been unrest and violence.